Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is our seventh video in our lesson, or in our series, Fiqh of Inheritance Made Easy. In this lesson, inshallah, we're going to wrap up the individuals who can inherit the way of fractional shares in the Quran. We have arrived at a final fractional share, which is a sudus, sixth. Now, those who can potentially inherit a sixth are seven individuals, as you can see on the screen. The first individual is the father. The father inherits a sixth as long as there is a fara' warith present. As long as there is a fara' warith present, then the father will inherit a sixth. قال الله تعالى وَلِأَبَوَيْهِ لِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَ السُّدُسُ مِمَّا تَرَكَ إِنْ كَانَ لَهُ وَلَدٍ إِنْ كَانَ لَهُ وَلَدٍ. So as long as there is a progeny for the mayyit, and there is a father or a mother present, then in this case the father will inherit a sixth. The second individual who can inherit a sixth is the mother. The mother, he said, she inherits a third if there are two conditions met and it's not an Umari issue. The two conditions were no fara' warith and no multiple brothers or sisters of the mayyid. So that means that if there is a fara' warith, or if there are multiple brothers or sisters for the mayyid, then the mother drops from a third to a sixth. The third individual who can inherit by way of al-fard and earn a sixth is al-jadd, the grandfather, the paternal grandfather. And that's on the condition that there is no father and there is a fara' warith present, meaning there is no father blocking him and there is a fara' warith present. If these two conditions are met, then the grandfather, the paternal grandfather, will earn a sixth. The next individual, the fourth person, is the jaddah, the grandmother. The grandmother inherits a sixth on the condition that there is no mother present. There is no mother present. But even this, of course, we're looking at it from the angle of the closest grandmothers and mothers to the mayyit. Of course, what in ala, those masail will talk about it later. For example, what if a person dies, he left behind a great grandmother and a grandmother? Then in this case, the grandmother inherits and the great grandmother doesn't inherit. Rather, the great grandmother is blocked by the grandmother because she's closer to the mayyit than the great grandmother. But we're talking about here, generally speaking, that the grandmother, she will inherit a sixth if there is no mother present. And of course, the grandmother here applies across both maternal and paternal. The next is the mother's child, and this differs from the mother's children in that in the mother's children they are multiple, whereas here it is singular. So if the mother's children are multiple and the other conditions that we mentioned for the thuluth apply, no fara' warith, no asl warith, dhakar present, right, if these conditions are met, then they share between them one third equally. فَإِنْ كَانُوا أَكْثَرَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ فَهُمُوا شُرَكَاءُ فِي ثُلُثٍ. But if it's just one mother's child and the other conditions are met, i.e. there's no fara' warith, there's no asl warith, dhakar present, then in this case, the mother's child will get a sixth. قال الله تعالى وَإِنْ كَانَ رَجُلٌ يُورَثُ كَلَالَةً وَامْرَأَةٌ وَلَهُ أَخٌ أَوْ أُخْتٌ فَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا السُّدُسُ فَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا السُّدُسُ. So the mother's child, if it's one of them, meaning it's not multiple, and there is no fara' warith present, and there is no asl warith, dhakar present, then they earn a sixth. But if they are multiple, then they share between them one third equally. The last two masail revolves around a sudusu takmilatan li thuluthayn, a sixth to complete of two thirds, and they occur in the case of a sister from the father's side and a son's daughter. If you have a sister from the father's side and there is no mu'assib for her, meaning there is no brother basically, and likewise you have in the equation a full sister who inherits a half fardhan, you have a full sister who inherits a half fardhan present in the equation. Mathalan, a person died and he left behind a full sister, a sister from the father's side, and an uncle. Here, the full sister gets a half. She deserves a half. Fardhan. Why? Because the conditions are met. There is no ma'asib. They are not multiple sisters. There's no asl warith present. And there's no fara' warith present. You see? And so therefore, she gets or deserves a half. Now, when it comes to the sister from the father's side, in this scenario, since we have in the equation a full sister present who's earning a half or is getting a half, and likewise there is no ma'asib for this sister from the father's side, we therefore give this full half sister or the sister from the father's side a sixth takmilatan li thuluthayn, a sixth to complete of two thirds, and as for the uncle, he gets the remaining ta'siban. طيب. What about this is son's daughter? Again, the son's daughter, if there is no ma'asib present, meaning there's no son, and you have in the equation a daughter who is inheriting a half, farzan, and she is present in this problem, and she deserves a half. Then in this case, if there is no mu'asib to the son's daughter will get a sixth to complete of two-thirds. Meaning that if we were to combine the share of the sister, if we were to combine the share of the daughter and the son's daughter, it will come up to two-thirds. A half plus a sixth, two-thirds. In, likewise, in the case of the sister from the father's side, a half plus a sixth gives you two-thirds. That's why it's called as-sulusu takmilatan lithuluthayn. مثلا, a person died, he left behind a son, left behind a daughter, he left behind a daughter, a son's daughter, and a uncle. Right, similar to the previous case. A daughter, a son's daughter, and an uncle. The daughter here gets a half. Why? Because there is no son, there's no ma'asib, and there's no other daughter. Right, so she gets a half in this equation. As for the son's daughter, then there is no son present, and we have in the equation a daughter who is inheriting a half in this mas'ala. Therefore, we say that the son's daughter gets a sixth to complete of two-thirds. As for the uncle, he gets the remaining. Ta'asiban. He gets what remains. Ta'asiban. And so with that, we are able to figure out the seven individuals who can potentially inherit a sixth under conditions required for each one to inherit a sixth. And with that, we are able to now understand and know those who can inherit by way of al-farz. These are the only individuals, all that we mentioned over the last four lessons, they are the only ones who can inherit by farz. We mentioned those who inherit a half, and they are five. The husband, with the conditions mentioned. The daughter, with the conditions mentioned. The son's daughter, with the conditions mentioned. The full sister, with the conditions mentioned. And the sister from the father's side, with the conditions mentioned. Those who inherit a fourth is the husband, with the condition mentioned, and the wife, with the condition mentioned. As for those who can inherit an eighth, then it's the wife, of course, with the condition mentioned. Those who inherit two-thirds, we said that we take those who inherit a half, remove the husband, and we multiply them, and we make them into more than one. And we keep the conditions that we mentioned in the case of a half. So we say daughters, sons, daughters, full sisters, sisters from the father's side. And the conditions that we mentioned for a half also come into play. But we just switch when we say no other daughter, no other son's daughter, no other sister, no other sister. We just multiply that and make it more than one. As for those who inherit a third, we said they are two, generally speaking, the mother with the conditions mentioned, and likewise the mother's children, awladuhum, with the conditions mentioned, and they share the third equally between them. And we expect in this lesson talking about those who inherit a sixth, those seven individuals, the dad, the mum, the grandfather, the grandmother, the mother's child, right, singular, and likewise the mas'ala of as-sulus takmilatan lithuluthayn for the sister from the father's side and the son's daughter. طيب هذا والله الموفق لا إله غيره وصلبي بإذن الله سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.